Okay, it's October 20th, 2019. 2:01 p.m. The garden is done. We picked about 5 gallons of tomatoes before we left a bunch of small green ones on there. Not gonna pick any more of them off. There's probably about another 20 tomatoes on there. See, there's even some ripening right there. I don't know, those are questionable. I don't know if we'll get them or not. Okra, I think I might have some pods on there I might get. And we finished off everything for the pit. Now that summer's over with and fall is just about, it's gonna rain tonight. We bought the fire pit. I think it was from Lowe's. It's down in the ground. Dug out a hole, put about 50 pounds of sand down there and put the fire pit on top, black one with the removable top. And then we put 3 rows of cinder block, not cinder block, but this triangle stone like. And I'd like to get another 15 to finish up, make it 4 high. And then that's a tote with little pieces of wood and parts of the sunflower stems for like fire starter. These are the bigger branches and a couple of small tree trunks that were quartered for me. I got in there, put a couple of cinder blocks down with a couple of poles and the piece of junk swimming pool. Hang on angles like a V so we can put them in there and stack them. This tarp is for the porch swing, which we had on one time, and the wind took this thing off, knocked the swing over, and everything else. So unless you're not out here like this, 360 acres of Monsanto food-like product, genetically modified poison, basically. The winds out here are really, really bad. When they say they're like 10 to 12 miles an hour, they're about 18 to 30 miles an hour out here. So there's my volcano that's all messed up. I'm saving it because that would be an absolute emergency to go to. I'd like to get another one for around $100. Got the propane kit for it upstairs. Never used it on this one, but I could use it on a new one. But it got bent up and broke because I just didn't take care of it. Left it sit out in the weather, got rained on and so forth. But anyway, fire pit, fire starter, and firewood. And they cut down all the toxic GMO soybeans out here. The number one product from Monsanto that most people just can't get enough of. They chopped that down yesterday. 360 acres of open air now, all winter. So that's the north side of the house. That's the chimney. That's the original place of the cabin. That's the cabin. Each window on each side of that chimney was the original cabin. They enclosed the back porch, which made a small kitchen in there, and added a room on front there. That's our bedroom, believe it or not, with the front door right there. But with the alarm, the surveillance we have on this property, and plus weapons, of course, and booby traps, I'm fairly confident I ain't got to worry about laying in bed and someone trying to break in my door. I'd be so in fear for my life, I couldn't say what's going on. I would just have to react. And that's where our shed used to be until that F1 tornado tore it up off the 2x4s, or 1x6s, or 2x6s I put down in the ground and actually used wood screws and screwed the shed into it. And it actually picked it off that platform, which went about to where that tomato plant is there. So that's about 5-6 feet in from the edge of the porch that way, 6 feet to the other end of the shed. Picked it up. Didn't hit anything over here. Didn't hit my solar panel, which was a little bit further back. Didn't hit the propane tank, but it crashed it into that tree. If you look at a video from January 1st, I think it was December 31st is when that happened. So it actually lifted up, and I was on that porch where I just saw in air it flying by right there, and I went right into that tree and crunched it. And it sat there for about a week and a half, 2 weeks. And then the winds blew it off the tree. It was bent. It was wrapped around that tree. And I didn't know how we were going to get it. But the winds out here, well, it worked for me. And it unbent it a little, knocked it back into the yard here. Started to blow it north, because north is that way now. East is directly in front. So it blew that shed over that way. And then I just called some people to come get it. And then they came and they started dismantling it into piece by piece and took it. So yeah, all this stuff is mainly there's 90% basil out there, purple basil and green basil, lemon. And there's a monarch, it looks like a monarch butterfly on that one, if I can zoom in that way off this P piece of crap Sony shutting off. I think that's a, yeah, that's a Monarch on it right there. I can't sit still off my hands. But see those orange flowers there? Those are torch sunflowers. Those attract large winged butterflies and especially monarchs, which is one reason I grow them every year. This year we only have like three or once we've got a couple right here in number one garden. And I got one back there. One right there in the edge of number three. One in the middle of number three. And one in the back middle of number three. So, and then that's all basil. That's all basil back there. And here's a bunch of tomatoes that I left over. All heirloom too, by the way, so. Elderberry bushes. Planted these a year and a half ago. Got disease, got bugs on them and everything else. And again, there's nothing I can do out here. Again, when you have open like this, you're susceptible to like 90% of anything that can damage it. Winds are the main thing. That right there in the middle was a little spring, that, a little spring off that came from one of these, and I just planted to see if it would grow, and it's growing. So, and Lucy and CJ's chimes are going right now. Best case scenario is if we come across a large sum of money, oh, let's say $30 million, let's just say Mega Millions. I'm going to pay someone to take down there, go over and take that all out, put it in a wooden crate for me because we're taking them with us. And I'll even put the soil back down here for Mr. Thomas. But that's it. It's about 72 degrees out here right now. I've got about close to 3,000 gallons of reserve water. It's not clean. It's not dirty either, but it's just rainwater. It got brown and green from the leaves, but I drained it down all the way except for about 2 inches from the bottom. I just filtered it a little bit, and just everything else is water. That's emergency water for bathing. I've got a filter. I can filter it if I needed to drink it. So, but I've got at least 1,000 gallons of water at least out here right now. So maybe this November, so come out here and get a fire going. If it's not windy, again, we have spy satellites that come up here all the time. Even flip them off a couple times, and that damn thing turned its motor on and went that way, like going toward Jackson Airport. Because they're out here. Don't think they're not. At night, I see them all the time bobbing around. So, you have no privacy outside. Remember that, folks. Don't think you do. Don't think you should, because you don't. Not in this country. Not in the United States of America. You're in the United States, which is the corporation itself. So, I just want to get a video. This is, all right, 8 minutes. So, just showing what we did real quick. We picked it up and put the wood on there. And that's the cover, like I said. It was on the swing that it blew over right away. After a week, we had it blow over, blew the swing over and everything else. We got the canopy in half upstairs in the add-on attic. Dude, that's another thing. Each side of that chimney was the living room. This was a log cabin from 1890-something. Okay, that window, that room was added on. Those two windows, that room was added on. You can see the bottom of that eave right there. That was the cabin. That was added on upstairs, too. It's just a straight room up there. It's unfinished. Lots of wasps. Lots of garbage. Not garbage, just stuff thrown about. Those tomatoes and all that get tore up. Basil over here. Whew. Yeah. I'm in fear for my life, for anybody that comes out here after dark, especially, because no one needs to be out here after dark. So, there's a video about that, too, if you look, about some lucky people who were out here. I was here by myself when it happened, and I got one of my dogs barked at it. I had to go to the bathroom really bad, which was stupid, but I was armed, I'll say that much. Ran to the bathroom, and then went to the alarm and shut it off like an idiot instead of just coming out the front door and sound it. But they had pulled off and started driving down that road. You'll see it on the video. I don't know if I have that all on video too. I think I just, after I got back in the house is when I did the video. And that was sometime in August, I believe. Oh, gosh. I did that hummingbird feeder. There was one here about a week ago, roughly. That's the only reason we left one out here. Now there's nothing. They're gone. They're the only illegals that I know of that are trying to get back south of the border. Yeah. See all those butterflies? It looks like monarchs. It does look like a monarch. There's one that's similar to a monarch too, but there are monarchs. I've seen them up close. And they're all around the torch sunflowers. So anyway, 360 acres of barren land now. Monsanto genetically modified food-like product poison is what was put on here, and if you want to call it harvested, collected. I like to say it was collected. A harvest is what you do with food. When you get Monsanto up, you're collecting it. You're not harvesting it. So that's it. Unless the communists, socialist communists that call themselves Democrats now, which is a real joke, do something bizarre, that man right there will be our president for another 16 years. So.